Hello, welcome to the first lesson. Before we start the exercises or start learning about the features, I'll introduce you to the overall look of the Procreate Pocket in this lesson first. Once you open the app, you'll find the gallery page that has all the projects we've done. As for those who just downloaded the app, you'll see the sample projects that the app has prepared for you. If you don't see as many projects as I'm seeing, don't panic. The projects you're seeing on my screen are the projects that I prepared to be used in this course. Let's start with the select and see what it can do. Once you click it, you'll see a small circle in each project, which allows you to choose any projects you want. I'll choose three of them and click more to see further options. We can choose Stack to combine the chosen projects in one file. Click Select again. We'll take a look at the next option. The next one is Preview, which allows you to see the project without actually opening it. The Share option is for sharing our files with different formats to choose from. You can choose whichever type of file you want to share. I have a separate lesson that explains this in detail as well. The Duplicate is for copying the project. You'll get one more exact same project by using Duplicate. The next one is Import, which is used for importing files from different channels. If you choose On My iPhone, it'll import the existing files from our device. You can also import the file from other channels such as iCloud Drive, Google Drive, and Dropbox, or any other channels that you have. The Photo option allows us to import files from our device's gallery. This plus icon is to add a new project that will start from creating a new canvas. You'll notice that there are different sizes of canvas to choose from. We usually use the screen size for the canvas. But if you want to post your work on Instagram, I recommend choosing square. I won't force you to use a specific size. You can choose the size you want. I'll choose the screen size. Now we have an empty canvas and you can paint anywhere on it. I want you to look at the left side. You'll see the brush control that you can use for adjusting the brush size here. The one below is for adjusting the opacity and pressure of the brush. The lower you adjust it, the more faded the color will look. If you increase it, the color will become more distinct. I want everyone to always set this at 100%. If you feel like the color is too faded while painting, this is the first place to check if it's at 100%. The next one is Modify. There are many tools and settings here. The first option, Actions, has various tools to choose from. It includes different settings and sharing files, which I'll explain in detail later. Next is the Adjustments option, which is used for editing the picture. You can adjust the colors, the brightness, the blur, etc. The third option is Selection. I'll go through each tool in detail for the Modify again later. Then the last one, the transform option used for adjusting, minimizing, maximizing, and moving the picture. In addition, there are the tools in the tab on top, which I'll explain about them in the next lesson. Let's go!
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please like or leave a comment and subscribe to my channel. As a thank you, loyal subscribers receive a 10% discount on my Procreate Pocket Beginner. Check the description for coupon code. See you in the next video.